Hello, welcome back to the channel. Today we're going to talk about connecting Log4OM into WIN4ICOM or WIN4YAESU. You'll need a few things installed here. You'll need WIN4ICOM or WIN4YAESU. You will need COM0COM installed. There's a video on my channel of how to install that and get it working. You'll need OmniRig installed. There's a video for that on my channel, and you'll need, let's say, Log4OM. I'm guessing you've already got that. I will show you how to connect them all up. This won't take long. In settings for WIN4ICOM, make sure it's connected to your radio directly, and when you turn the VFO, it actually changes frequency like it's doing now. So that's that bit there. Then what you do is you connect COM0COM to WIN4ICOM. So we'll do it here. You'll need to use one of these that has the echo ability. So in here, we're going to connect 11. 11 is this number here. Think of this as a virtual cable, a serial cable. 11 is one end, 12 is the other. We're going to connect the 11 end into here. So we're selecting 11. Select a baud rate of 9600. That's a safe one to pick. And just type in a tag. We'll call this OmniRig. Then you make sure you've got echo connected or ticked, and then click connect. Okay, that's it. Click save, forget about it. Okay, so we've now got WIN4ICOM connected to COM0COM here. Now what we can do is we can go to OmniRig. If we bring up OmniRig from the start menu, and we can point OmniRig to the other end of the cable, which is 12. So let's do that. We'll select 12. And everything else, make sure we've got the correct baud rate, 9600, because that's what we selected on the other end of the cable. And everything else is fine. Just put in what you would normally put in. Okay, OmniRig is now connected to this end of the cable. So OmniRig is connected to WIN4ICOM through COM0COM. So anything we point at OmniRig now can also talk to your radio. So if we go into program configuration, and within here you've got cat control, just make sure you select OmniRig from this drop down. OmniRig, cat auto start. You can see all the other settings I've got. I don't use Log4OM, so I don't know whether you would normally have other things ticked here, but I'm sure you can figure that out for yourself. That's all you need to do. Within here, I don't have that ticked. That's the thing. Make sure you've got OmniRig selected from this drop down. Save and apply. And then hopefully if we go into here, cat, let's stop it and start it. Good. There we go. It's working. Came straight up. You can now see Log4OM is tracking the frequencies. So that's the trick there. When you add a new virtual COM port pair, you do need to restart your computer for it to actually recognize across the system. Happy days. I hope that's helped somebody out. Andy M7XTT, I think it is, asked me to make this video. He was asking some questions on one of my YouTube videos, so I said I'd make this video to help him out. Hopefully it's helped somebody else. If you'd like me to do a demonstration on how to get something working in terms of cat control software, if I know the answer, I'll happily make a video, so just leave it in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe if you enjoy or found this useful. There'll be many more videos like this coming out in the future on the channel. 73s for now. Bye bye.